अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई एम योर इंस्ट्रक्टर डॉक्टर राबिया। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर नंबर 2, दैट इज अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ जेनेटिक्स। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू अबाउट द फंडामेंटल ऑफ जेनेटिक्स एंड सम रिलेटेड डेफिनेशन अबाउट जेनेटिक्स। द टर्म जेनेटिक वाज फर्स्ट टाइम यूज्ड बाय द बैटिसन। Genetics actually the study of heredity and variations. In my previous video, I have told you about the heredity, variations and inheritance. Heredity actually the study of transmission of genetic characters from parents to the offsprings, while variations are the differences that are seen among the members of same species. So these are the differences that we observe in the member of the same species. And inheritance is actually the process by which genetic characters are transferred from parents to the offspring. In order to develop the genetic characters, following conditions are required. Number one, gene should be present. Number two, gene should be expressed. Number third, for expression, suitable condition is required. So we can say that in order to study the genetics that related with the transfer of characters, there must be presence of gene and its expression is required, and the expression occurred during the suitable conditions. So here you can see, for example, we have a growth hormone that is a factor, and its gene is located on the chromosomes. From the chromosome, the gene will form the protein and it will transfer to the RNA, and then RNA will form the protein. Protein are the enzymes that will act upon the suitable substrate. The substrate will form the product. RNA and protein enzymes actually are the expression. So when the product is height, so height is the genetic character. So this is how the genetic character transfer. There should be a presence of a certain character genes, then it must be expressed under the certain conditions. This is how the genetic characters transmissions work. So the history of the genetic research work started by the Mendel. So Mendel, George Mendel, is the Gregor Mendel is the father of genetics, while Bateson is the father of modern genetics. What the Bateson proposed? He proposed various terms like genetics, alleles, homozygous and the heterozygous. While T.H. Morgan is the father of experimental genetics. So the pure genetics start from the work of Mendel, while the modern father of genetics is the W. Bateson, and the father of experimental genetics is the T.H. Morgan. As we know, he performed the experiment on Drosophila. He proposed various concepts like linkage, sex linkage, crossing over, crisscross inheritance. He suggested that genes are linearly arranged on chromosomes. For example, here in the figure you can see that this is the chromosome and there are the genes A, B, C, D, E, F. These are the genes that are linearly arranged on the chromosomes. A. Garrod, father of human genetics and the biochemical genetics. What he has done? He discovered first human metabolic genetic disorder. That is the black urine disease, alkaptonuria. Some genetical terms. In most of the genetics, there are certain terms that we have to use again and again, and we must know the definition of these. First, for example, we use the term characters. Characters are the any feature of an organism. For example, stem, height, flower color, trait mean variable form of characters. The stem height, it may be tall or it may be dwarf. If we talk about the flower color, it may be red or it may be pink. So these are the difference between the character and the trait. Here in the figure you can see that trait height and the height as a character, tall, and the dwarf are the two traits of that height character. Mendel used the term element or the factor instead of genes, while the Johnsons used the term the genes, and the genes are the segment of DNA that is responsible for the appearance of the characters. These are the segment of DNA that generally synthesize RNA and proteins. So the genes are the unit of inheritance. Chemically, the gene is a DNA. All genes are DNA, but all DNAs are not genes. For example, we have a chromosome, and inside the chromosome there is a thread-like structure. You can see these are the DNA, and the genes are located on the DNA. From the DNA, the information will be transferred to the RNA, and the RNA will form the protein like, and then it will express the character, that is height. Similarly, the gene of the color is will located on the DNA. It will transfer to the RNA. It will form the protein, and then the character will be the color. So these are the expression of the height character and the color characters. One more terminology we most oftenly use in the genetics, that is the allele. Allele is the alternate form of a gene. It occurs due to the mutation. Allele are present at the same locus on homologous chromosome. So the alleles are also located on the homologous chromosome. Here you can see the expression of, this is the RNA, protein, and tall. Homozygous chromosomes, this you can say here you can see the homologous chromosomes, and these are the homologous chromosomes which form the, after evolution, dominant allele, RNA, protein, and tall. This is allele, and then alternative form, then mutation occur, and another allele, that is a recessive allele, which will not be expressed. So the tall will be the dominant allele, while the dwarf is the recessive allele that not expressed. For example, if we ask a question with reference of the following, which one of the following is correct presentation of allele? Number one option is there are the four options, and here you can see that the fourth one is the correct answer, because these are the located on the homologous chromosomes, not on the same chromosomes. Unmodified allele, wild allele, or original type. Allele which is present in nature form from starting, generally unmodified allele is dominant allele. Mean that the allele that is present in the parents are the dominant allele. Modified allele is that allele which occurs after the mutation, formed by the mutation, and the generally modified allele is recessive allele. So the dominant allele is always the unmodified allele, or the modified allele is actually the recessive allele that present in the offsprings. So this is the history about the genetics. Thank you so much for watching my video. See you next time with a new video. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.